The NSAS protest, initially a call by Nigerian youths for the disbandment of the Special Anti-Robbery Squad, later on metamorphosed into a call for good governance. The protest at some point turned violent when hoodlums ejected, resulting into wanton destruction of property and loss of lives. With the suspension of the protest and normalcy gradually returning to many parts of the country, what are the lessons to be learned from the NSAS protest? This is Report on ITV, and I'm Blessing Aichi.
Those businesses that have been plundered, we kept on saying that every businessman, every running business should have adequate insurance policy. Adequate insurance policy in terms of fire, special perils, and consequential losses arising out of riot and civil disobedience and civil commotion.
It's a win-win situation. Why I call it is a win-win situation is now the government, Abinico, realize that they are disconnected from the people. We need followership orientation. We realize that it's not proper for us to be destroying things that belongs to our collective use. Because some of those people that said that, why I say two wrongs cannot make a right by destroying some of the government is or other things, is because when you feel like the BRT case in Lagos, it's the same common man that used BRT in Lagos. Like if you see some of the vaccines that were destroyed in Benin, in medical store, it's the same common man that cannot avoid all those vaccines. So the big men, they go to Europe, they go to other parts of the continent. But at least now, there will be a time for replanning. Both the led and the followers, they are replanning. And at the end of the day, both parties will come into a critical thinking. Right now, as I speak with you now, the youth are beginning to think critically. Because in the past, the youth is like they were not thinking. They were only thinking of today. But today now, the youth are beginning to think of tomorrow.
We have a lot to learn. First and foremost, the leaders need to be very conscious of whatever they are doing. From this protest, you can see that most of the youth, they are hungry. It's not only because of the sacks. There is hunger in the town, no job, cost of living is on the high side. So the government needs to be very wise. At least they have to put their home in order. And this youth also should also be wise. They need to cooperate to make sure that whenever the government is doing wrong, there is need for peaceful protest. The heart of vandalizing government properties or destroying people's properties ought not to be. These are the lessons we need to learn.
The lesson I think we have learned is on both sides, both the populace and the leaders, or those who are governed and those who govern us. If we take it from the view of the wanton destruction on public properties, you will really see that there was some level of misunderstanding of who owns whatever is built that you call government building. We are part of government. It's just for some time you must have some persons who are there as rulers. But I think why some persons went to either burn or destroy public buildings is from the view of, this is a government property and it's as if it belongs to those who are in a position of authorities. And for those who govern us, I think now we are now saying we will respond to the five demands made by the NSAS protesters. The question is that did we really need to wait till this point to know that we'll respond to this? Because during electionary campaigns, you hear most of these leaders, even on their own, vowing to address most of these things that have to take us protests for them to now start talking of addressing. So in all, I think on both sides, we should learn to take a role or a position. As those who are governed, we should know that whatever is built, whatever public building, public structure, belongs to us all. And for those who govern, you would also know that they are just there in the position of authority for the now, and they must be accountable to the people.
One of the lessons is there that we Nigerians should learn is that we should not believe in fake rumor. The social media has really done a great loss to this very protest. Where the NSAS people, they met well by coming out to speak for the entire youth of the country. And in fact, not just the entire youth, we the pensioners, the workers, because things are really difficult. The setback is that the hoodlums that hijacked the process, they've not met well for Nigerians.
The youth, they have spoken, they've spoken to the government. The government, they have started working on what the youth want from them. So government are responding to the youth concerning the NSAS protest. With the destruction and everything, what we want, it won't come out that way, like majorly. But peace is just okay. With peace, I think so. They will listen to us.
The lessons are not fully learned. It's still an ongoing lesson. But from the one we can specifically refer to and assume to be lessons that have been learned from this process, is the dangerous nature of spreading, sustaining and believing in fake news, which is a major problem we have right now. And then secondly, and more importantly, the notion that people can be taken for granted in this society. It is a state of enough is enough. Government now realize that everything is not as it seems with a lot of persons and people who reside in our societies and our cities. So, but they are not going to come out to protest, but they are not happy. And then more importantly, and if you permit me to use the word finally, the police have also realized too that they are accountable to the poor at the end of the day. That they are there to do just one thing, protection of lives and property. And it must come with a minimal legal position, which is the rule of engagement that must be enforced and sustained by them. The youth too, we also know that they should also know clearly that they cannot afford to endanger their society. A lot of persons went to the different prisons to go and open up the gates. Today, a lot of the people who open up the gate are after them. They have created a monster. Some of them can't sleep with their eyes closed now.
They have been able to bring out that consciousness among Nigerians that when their people are not satisfied with the way things are, they can organize themselves to cry out. And again, too, now, that lesson for me that our elected officers should know that the people are watching. Doesn't follow if the people don't cry out when certain wrong policies are being made. But let them know that periodically, if care is not taken, the people might be tempted to cry out. And that was just happened. And again, too, government must learn how to respond to issues. We should not allow things to degenerate to a level whereby no institution of government be able to take response. Like what happened in the NSAS era. This issue of NSAS has been on for over 10 years.
Having itemized the lessons from the NSAS protest, it is the submission of respondents that a culture of accountability has been birthed in Nigeria. I'm Blessing Aichi.